Hello, this is Rick Ridings coming to you from Succat Hallel in Jerusalem with another prayer update. It's April 3rd, day 180 of the war with Hamas. And I want to share on three areas, something I believe God has given to us in a fresh way about Gaza, and then concerning gaps in the wall and protection for Israel at this key time when Iran is making major threats against Israel, and then government and stability in the government of Israel. Let's start with the gates. Saturday, as we were worshiping the Lord here, the Lord made very real to me a scripture in Judges chapter 16. It says, the people of Gaza were told Samson is here. So they surrounded the place, they lay in wait for him all night at the city gate. They made no move during the night, saying at dawn, we'll kill him. So they had their whole plan, and it had to do with the gates of Gaza. But Samson lay there early until the middle of the night. Then he got up and he took hold of the doors of the city gates. Now, city gates in those days were huge. We've seen one in the museum that was a city gate of ancient Gaza at this time. And it says that he took hold of the doors of the city gate together with its two posts, and he just tore them loose, bar and all. And he lifted them on his shoulders and carried them to the top of the hill that faces Hebron. So this supernatural strength came upon Samson to just rip up the gate of Gaza that was barred with iron. And this was a big, heavy door and the walls of the city. But he just ripped it up and took it away. And I felt like the Lord said, a greater than Samson is here. Samson was flawed. He could only do these things when the Spirit of the Lord came upon him. But Jesus, Yeshua, is greater than Samson with all power, with all might. And I felt like he was speaking to us that the gates represent the way that Satan thinks that he has gated in the people of Gaza, that they cannot receive the gospel, that there's been so much persecution of Christians there. We had a good friend, Gazan, who was beaten to death because of the name of Jesus there in Gaza. And the intense persecution and oppression of Hamas has kept the gospel from going forth in Gaza. But I felt like the Lord was encouraging us to believe that Jesus, Yeshua, will lift up this gate of Gaza that has kept the gospel of the kingdom of God and the light of God out of Gaza, and that he will carry it far away, and the gates will be broken. So the hold of Hamas, the Pharaoh-like hold of Hamas upon Gaza, will be broken. Their gates that they have put to keep out the gospel and the light of the kingdom will not succeed. But he himself will tear up those gates. And I believe with all my heart that we're going to see, when this war is finished, a mighty move of God in Gaza. We're believing for hundreds and thousands to come to the Lord, that large numbers of ministries could have the freedom, with Hamas out of the way, to come into Gaza and to minister to the needs of the people there physically and spiritually, and to see a real move of God in Gaza. And this fits in with the scripture that we've been proclaiming. Some of you have been proclaiming this with us from Zechariah 9. In verse 5, it says, Gaza will lose her king. We believe that refers to a time with the spiritual king and the physical leader, Sinwar, Hamas, who's like a pharaoh, like an evil king, that Gaza will lose her king. Verse 6, and I will put an end to the pride of the Philistines, in this case of Hamas, who identifies with the Philistines. I will take the blood from their mouths, the forbidden food from between their feet. We must remember that this whole war started by a barbaric a movement of blood. We were recently in the Gaza envelope, once again with teams visiting there, hearing again more stories of just the horrific things that occurred on October 7th. The blood, the sexual violence, the killing of parents in front of children, children in front of parents, babies abducted. Unbelievable things. But God says, I will take this blood from their mouths, the forbidden thing, food from between their teeth. Then he says, in verse 7, those who are left in Gaza will belong to our God and become a clan in Judah. Now, Judah was the tribe that was originally to dwell in Gaza, the tribe of praise. So he says, those who are left in Gaza will belong to our God, not the false moon god from Saudi Arabia, but the true and living God who made the moon and the stars, the God of Israel. They will become like a clan in Judah, in other words, a clan of praise. Ekron, one of the cities there, says will be like the Jebusites. The Jebusites were Gentiles, but who realized the call and anointing of God on King David and joined together to see David rule as king over Israel. So there'll be a change of heart. It's interesting, a prominent Orthodox Jewish rabbi published an op-ed recently that was published by the Washington Times in Washington, D.C., America. And it said, the only hope for Gaza is Jesus. He said, the only thing that will change Gaza, because he said, we can't just conquer it militarily. A mentality has to be changed. And he said, historically, the only place that radical, Islamic, violent, culture of death mentality changes is when large numbers of people in a nation come to Jesus. And so we're believing the Lord for this, for Gaza, and encourage you to believe with us for the people of Gaza. And then secondly, I want to talk about gaps. In a wall of protection, there are gaps, there are holes. We recently went with some Jewish Messianic young adults here and some older intercessors, Jewish Messianic intercessors, to the Nova Festival massacre site. And there we spent about 2 hours in prayer, in worship, in proclamation. These young adults asked God's forgiveness for the idolatry, the idol that was actually placed in that Nova Festival, and ask God's forgiveness that this had made a gap in the wall of protection, and ask for a redemption of the land, a building up of the wall, the gaps. And then we took communion together, we poured some of the wine into the ground and proclaimed that the blood of Jesus, the blood of Yeshua, speaks a better thing than the blood of innocent victims. And so we're believing the Lord that that gap is being built back up. Pray that the Lord will show the praying priesthood in this land how to stand in those places and fill up every gap. He said, I look for an intercessor among them to stand in the gap, to build up the gap, the breach in the wall. And at that time he could find none, but now he can. And we thank the Lord. So pray for the Messianic prayer movement in this land to know how to build up the wall of spiritual protection around this land, especially right now when Iran is making very vicious, strong threats against Israel. And that brings me to the last point. The last G is government. We need to pray for the stability of the government in Israel right now. There are outside forces joining with a very small minority of inside forces, but with very loud voices and lots of money, and trying to overthrow this government. The last thing Israel needs in the middle of a war is governmental instability. They need a government to continue on and to be in place. There is a unity government, and there are different voices in the war cabinet. It needs to stand strong. This is not the time to call out for elections in Israel. That is going against what Israel has been called at this time to do, which is to deal with and uproot Hamas. They need to be able to focus upon that and not be divided by voices calling for elections, calling for change of government. This is not the time. So we encourage you to pray for governmental stability and just a peace of God to come, that they will stand strong against the increased Iranian threats, Hezbollah threats, and finish the task of uprooting Hamas out of Gaza. We thank you for all of you that have been praying and standing with us, and we're just so blessed that we are not alone in the spiritual battle for this city of Jerusalem, but you're standing together with us in the nations. God bless you as you continue to stand as watchmen on the walls of Jerusalem.